It's late evening, and as you're strolling leisurely on your way home, you come across a crying man sitting on the side of the street. Being the sensitive and responsible, gentle person you are, you can't just pass this poor man by. The stranger looks up. You try to meet his gaze, but there isn't one. He simply doesn't have eyes. Under his eyelids, you can see only a black void and a thin stream of tears sliding down his cheeks. Are you dreaming? Is this a nightmare? How realistic is this situation? And can a person really cry without eyes? But before we unveil this horrifying secret, let's look at why our eyeballs become wet in the first place when we experience different things like joy and sadness. According to one hypothesis, at a time before we even became Homo sapiens, liquid coming from one's eyes reduced one's ability to see, demonstrating to enemies and predators that we archaic humans weren't dangerous. But somehow I doubt that a sobbing caveman aroused much sympathy with, say, your average everyday saber-toothed predator. Reflex tears, also known as irritant tears, are much more explicable. They come to one's eyes when a stimulus appears, such as, obviously, an irritant. They appear when, for example, you cut an onion or sit close to a fire and the smoke gets in your eyes. In such a case, the sensory nerves in the cornea notice a foreign object in your eye and report this to the brain. In turn, the large hemispheres of gray matter in your skull send a signal back, commanding the interlopers and invaders to be immediately rinsed off with moisture and washed out and away. The second most common cause of tears is emotions. When a strong feeling such as pain, happiness, or fear overwhelms you, the brain reacts to the stress by activating the lacrimal glands. Those are the glands that pump out the tears, the eye's waterworks, as it were. Fascinatingly, the composition of the tear fluid varies depending on the cause of the cry. Reflex tears are 98% water, but emotional stress causes us to excrete a substance that includes some chemical elements that help to relieve pain and improve mood. Long story short, if you cut an onion you don't have any feelings for, then you get reflex tears. But if you are a fruitarian and genuinely pity the poor vegetable, then those are emotion tears running down your cheeks. However, if crying for adults is a way to wash tiny invading substances out of their eyes or to express their feelings, for babies, it's an entire language, and each one of them has its own. An international group of researchers from the University of Würzburg came to the conclusion that the cry of a baby is directly dependent on the type of language that the mother uses. If the mother uses a tonic form of speech where the stress in words is shown by an increase in tone, then the cry of her baby will be rather diverse in sound frequencies. And on the contrary, if the mother speaks in an atonic or monotonic form where all of the syllables in words are spoken at the same frequency, then her baby will cry more steadily. Fortunately, after a period of time, we start using human speech instead of tears and crying to request that our parents feed us, whereupon we then only cry on specific occasions and for very particular reasons. For example, crying from happiness when a new Riddle episode is released. There is a difference in how long you may cry, depending upon the level of your emotional attachment to my show, and also depending upon your gender, as some Dutch researchers documented not so long ago. To wit, a team of scientists from Tilburg University in the Netherlands determined the average duration of a good cry. For this, they had to get 5,000 intrepid men to weep. These courageous fathers, sons, uncles, and grandpas emotionally sacrificing themselves for the sake of science. According to the results, guys cease crying much faster than girls. 65% of men returned to baseline in about 5 minutes, with longer crying spells associated with intense fear, humiliation, and disappointment. As for the fairer sex, the most common cause for a woman to cry is helplessness or happiness, with only 40% returning to a normal emotional state after 5 minutes. But to recover from a very strong negative emotion like guilt, fear, or humiliation, the females of our species need up to 15 minutes. And there were a few subjects of both sexes who shed tears for over half an hour. Luckily, after a while, any crying jag will end. They don't go on forever. Thank goodness, or we might create whole rivers out of our tears. But before you get the bright idea of traveling to the Sahara Desert and trying to humidify that parched wilderness with your waterworks, let's figure out first if such a thing is even possible. Lucky for us, some students at the University of Leicester in England decided to find out if it would be possible for all humans on Earth to weep a river and fill an Olympic-sized swimming pool. Replication of the smallest river in the USA was decided upon as a goal for the research. It's called the Roe River, and it's just about 200 feet or 61 meters in length. The average volume of a single cry is 6 microliters, and a standard Olympic-sized pool holds 2.5 million liters of water. So, if every inhabitant of the planet captured just 55 of their tears and dropped them in, it actually would be enough to fill the pool. Draining the pool would create a river somewhat like the Roe. Remarkably, the Roe at 61 feet is the smallest in the States, but it is a veritable Mississippi compared to the smallest river in the world, the 10-foot or 3-meter-long Kuokkanjoki River in Finland. So I guess Justin Timberlake really knew what he was talking about when he sang Cry Me a River. So, unfortunately, if you want to swim in the tears of your enemies, this can only be done metaphorically. But back to where we started, crying in the absence of eyes, yes, can literally be accomplished. After all, the organs which give us sight and those that shed tears are not actually connected to each other. They're just really close. As previously mentioned, tears come from the special lacrimal glands in the corner or right next to the eye. As long as they're not damaged, you can cry as much as you want with or without eyes. Only those people whose lacrimal glands are damaged can't cry. The difference for people who have no eyes, they only cry for emotional reasons, so their tears are the more sincere. But you might wonder, is the opposite situation possible? By this I mean, can a person with eyes cry, but without any tears? In fact, there are people who cry completely dry, while experiencing incredible agony, pain, and misery. This phenomenon is called xerophthalmia, a disorder involving a painful drying of the cornea. This terrible disease isn't new and has been well studied by doctors. It appears due to chemical burns, infections, and hypovitaminosis, specifically a lack of vitamin A. Children suffering from nutritional deficiencies are hurt the most with this condition, with about 250,000 cases of childhood blindness still being recorded each year in developing countries. If an outwardly completely healthy adult person began to cry but his eyes remained dry, you'd better take him or her to the hospital. Xerophthalmia is one of the main signs of the infamous Sjogren's syndrome, a terrible disease which has no known cure. The disease damages connective tissues and destroys the salivary and lacrimal glands. A person affected by this disease suffers from excruciating eye pain and has difficulty speaking or even chewing food. With time, the syndrome progresses and affects the vital organs. But even in the early stages, life for a sufferer of this syndrome turns into pure torture. At the moment, modern medicine can only treat the symptoms of this malicious malady by replacing the missing fluids of the body. It's pitiful to think that even the sadness caused by the suffering of those struck by this disorder must be expressed somehow differently, as they have no tears to show just how much pain they are in. But there is one person on Earth who'd be more than happy to do away with their tears completely. This is because when this person cries, solid crystals form in their eyes. And no, we're not talking about Chuck Norris, who, if he cries at all, probably weeps tears of hot lava. We're actually talking about one Laura Pons, a simple primary school teacher from Brazil. this woman's lacrimal glands secrete some kind of white matter, which, upon contact with air, hardens and turns into sharp-edged crystals, causing her pain. The school teacher often has to take sick days in order to rid herself of the accumulation of her unusual and painful tears. The first time this incomprehensible substance appeared in her eyes was at the age of 15. And for the next 20 years, Laura and her family dedicated themselves to finding an explanation for where these crystal tears came from. After a series of tests, it turned out that this unusual disorder is caused by an excess of keratin, the protein that helps make hair, nails, and the outer layers of the skin. This protein can, unfortunately, appear at inappropriate times and in the wrong places. Under normal conditions, when a human is attacked by bacterial parasites, they get into a fight with a special substance called mucin. But in Laura's case, this doesn't happen, and so her body created a second line of protection. Her cornea secretes keratin, which, when mixed with other substances, turns into tiny little hard and sharp crystals. Doctors have, thankfully, finally figured out how to treat the appearance of these unusual tears. There is, however, still no cure for this bizarre disease. Thankfully for the rest of us, whether we have just tears or eyes or both or neither, we are all able to experience these feelings of joy and sorrow that make us truly human. If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Click on the bell button to be the first to know about our new videos. And stay with us, because the best of Riddle still lies ahead.